This is the feature attraction of the evening. It's time to lace up and throw down. 12 rounds of boxing for the Unified Lightweight Championship of the World. Boxing out of the blue corner and wearing the blue trunks. He weighed in at the lightweight limit of 135 pounds. He is undefeated, 21-0 with 7 knockouts. From Ploiești, Romania, now fighting out of Montreal, Quebec, Canada, the 1992 and 96 Olympic bronze medalist and WBA lightweight champion of the world, please welcome Leonard Dorin. And his opponent, boxing out of the red corner and wearing the black trunk. He weighed in at a fit and ready, 134.5 pounds. He is undefeated, 36 bouts, 14 by knockout. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the IBF and IBC lightweight champion of the world, the Pittsburgh Kid, Paul Spadafora. Spadafora.
Just getting a bit pumped up in that Spadafora corner, aren't they?
I expect a clean break at all times. Watch your low blows, watch your holding and hitting. Are there any questions? All right, touch gloves. Let's have a nice clean fight. Touch them up.
That rarity in world boxing, a unification fight here for the IBF and WBA lightweight championship. Spadafora, the IBF champ. Dorin, the WBA champion. But he hasn't fought for a year, Dorin, since he retained the title, fighting the bloke he won it from, Raul Balbi of Argentina. And you'll notice straight away that the southpaw Spadafora in the black trunks here is much, much taller and ought to have advantage if he can use that jab. Dorin has to get inside.
Well, Dorin is the shorter man, but as an amateur, in a very, very good career, he often fought at like welterweight, so he's used to the bigger men and especially the taller men.
There's also a bit of pressure on Spadafora here to put on a bit of a show for the television cameras. He's getting $500,000 for this, as is Dorin. He's already landed with one good right hand. Spadafora is a right-handed southpaw. In other words, there's probably a bit more dig in that jab than you'd normally expect.
Well, in his fights, he does rely on that jab an awful lot. That's predominantly what he is. He's a boxer behind the southpaw jab, and he'll be looking, using that height and reach, to keep Dorin at bay.
He's proved a resilient champion as well, Spadafora. Paul Paul, they call him around here, and you can see why. Good right hand again, though, from Dorin, who's quick-handed. And he's more than just a brawler. He's pretty clever with it as well. I don't think you pick up those amateur championships I was talking about without being a pretty good technician.
We have two good left hooks going in for Dorin there. He's got his timing right in from the very early on. Solid punches from Dorin. A lot of Spadafora is hitting the gloves.
HBO, the American TV people, wanted one of these to fight Floyd Mayweather, the big noise in this division, but Mayweather wanted $3 million, while one of these two picked up $250,000. They weren't having that, so they put these two together. Good fight between the world numbers 2 and 3. And a very, very good opening round. They haven't mucked about here.
They haven't. Spadafore elected to stand right in front of Dorian. Not sure that's a wise decision. For me, it hasn't been that wise in the opening round. He's picked up a couple of nice, clean punches from Dorian.
He's in range. Good left uppercut from Spadafora. And the right hook as well. But Dorian is having plenty of success. And his punches seem to have a bit of meat about them as well. Neither of them really noted as knockout artists, these two. If it carries on like this, it just might be memorable.
I'm thirsty. You want something?
If you're up.
I'm up. You want anything?
It's okay.
David, I'm in the kitchen. Can I get you anything?
What do you have?
A Coke.
That sounds good.
Are you sure?
Yes, please. Thank you, Cor.
Ice?
Yes, please. Thank you, baby.
You're welcome.
Right, and right in the middle, drop your head on this side. Drop your head.
Welcome back to the Peterson Event Center in the University of Pittsburgh. And we've seen a stirring opening round here in this world lightweight unification fight.
Yes, Dorian getting the better of it for me in the opening round. Good solid punches, and you know, he's just picking up the better punches of the two.
Dorian in the blue trunks, and I'm sure he'll be thinking that he needs to do this in spectacular style because he is boxing in Spadafora's hometown. Pittsburgh's not really been any kind of fight city. Spadafora used to draw crowds of about 10,000, not as many as that here today. A bit disappointingly, really, because it's a cracking looking fight on paper and not a bad one on canvas so far. And Dorian again rams home that straight right hand. He's having no trouble at all, is he, getting close enough to land?
He's not. Spadafora almost inviting him in. He's standing still. He's not moving a great deal. It looks as if Spadafora has a point to prove and wants to stand with Dorian.
Not the ideal strategy, you wouldn't think. Spadafora usually likes to do things behind the jab with a fast right hand. But he's quite happy here to let Dorian in toe-to-toe and work on the inside.
Watch your head, watch your head.
Good body shots, mind you, from Spadafora.
Well, maybe Spadafora adopting the option that because Dorian has only got 7 stoppage wins in 21, that he isn't a puncher and that he can stand in front of him and trade.
Well, let's see if that strategy is going to pay off for him. He's quite adept at just switching the angles almost imperceptibly, Spadafora.
Dorian, a good technical fighter. You see the way he gets the arms up, catches the punches of Spadafora on the gloves. It doesn't give him a target, and then comes back with the good counters.
Good right hand from Spadafora there on the counter as Dorian tried to come forward.
It was better for Spadafora, looking to put the punches together in bunches there.
The chemistry here is ideal for a good fight.
Well, it's a great mix. Orthodox southpaw, taller guy, shorter. 2 undefeated fighters. It really is a good mix.
Dorian, who used to box under the name of Leonard Dorofdai for Romania in his amateur days. But they didn't think Dorofdai was going to sell too well over in Canada and the United States. Hence the name Dorian.
Well, this is a better round for Spadafora, getting his range, now starting to get his timing, and just starting to put the punches together well.
Get off him, get off him, get off him.
Dorian, just not quite as effective as often. Maybe Spadafora nicked that one. I think here so far.
Give me another round like that. Busy with your hand.
The voice of Jesse Reed working the corner for Spadafora. Used to have Don Curry, Frank Tate, Orlando Canizales. Been around a bit as Jesse Reed. Good bloke to have in there.
Yes, very experienced. He was certainly a little more pleased with the work of Spadafora in that round, keeping him busy.
Spadafora beginning to get that jab going. Dorian, who turned pro pretty late at 28 after his glory years in the amateurs. He's 33 now, so they had to get a move on with him. This is only his 22nd pro fight. Good shots, Spadafora.
Well, I think it's very important for Spadafora to try and get off first. He's working well to the body, wants to bring those hands down of Doreen.
Doreen's blocking a lot, isn't he, on the arms and gloves. He gets it with a good right hand, that seems to register. The right hand from Doreen. I think Spadafora is going to have to dig in a few more punches to the body to try to get that guard of Doreen's down. Good in with a left hook as well, and there's a big right. And again from Doreen. He's having some round here, the Canadian-based Romanian, and yet again, this time Spadafora shakes his head, but Doreen is getting there in quite a big way in this round.
Well, he's really trying to impose himself, Doreen. And he's doing a good job in this round, pushing forward, just keeping the arms going out and connecting time and time again.
Doreen's cut by the right eye, though. And it looks quite serious as well. That he's having a memorable round here, and he's knocking a lot out of Spadafora, who keeps shaking his head. But maybe that's a clear sign to Doreen that he's definitely making an impression.
Well, he may shake that head, but he can't get that head out of the way of the punches in this round.
Spadafora's own defense looking sloppy, his left glove drooping low, and again he pays for it with the Doreen right hand. Doreen just lost his balance there was no knockdown. He did touch down with the gloves, but it was clearly no punch involved.
Well, this is a good exciting round, the crowd enjoying it.
Cracking stuff this from Doreen. A lot of people won't have seen him, they might have read about him in the boxing papers, but here he is showing everybody what he is about. And he has hit Spadafora with right after right after right in this round.
Well, terrific round for Doreen, really looking strong, rolling forward, much busier, and that was a big round for him.
Not quite a 10-8 round, but not far off it.
Well, Spadafora has picked up a nasty cut on the left eye, Doreen on the right eye, so they've got something to work for in that corner.
You look great. Don't pull out. That's when he's hitting you. Stay inside and just spin on him.
That was from the butt, his cut, right? No uppercut's going to get in there. Yeah. And listen, that right short hook inside, Leonard.
Yeah.
Uppercut and right left, right short hook. You hear me, Leo?
Yeah.
He's shut. He's
Stephen LaRouche is the trainer.
He's playing your game, Leo. He's playing your game.
Perfect.
They're saying that Spadafora is shot in Doreen's corner.
Well, they know he's picked up a cut. And look at the punches going in, very strong punches. He really was on top in that round.
I think they feel that Spadafora is ready to be taken. He certainly seemed to knock a lot out of him in that round, did Doreen. Doreen, who's about the biggest thing in sport in Romania, aside from the great footballer Georgi Hagi and the Olympic gold medalist Gabriel Szabo. He's a huge hero, and this fight is going out in Romania at 6 o'clock in the morning. They thought it was a knockdown. The referee, Rudy Battle, says no.
Well, the punch did seem to land, but obviously they just thought he twisted his legs a little bit. The crowd suddenly reacted.
There's that Doreen right hand again. He doesn't look as if he was hit with anything too significant, does he, the way he's fighting Doreen, which persuades me to believe that maybe the ref's right about that. It did look as if something landed, mind you.
Well, he's really getting some momentum into his shots now as he rolls forward. Doreen keeping the short hooks going in.
And a I'll tell you something, Floyd Mayweather might be the star at this weight, but these two are putting him in the shade with the kind of fight they're putting on here. There's been more excitement in this than in the last couple of Mayweather fights, I'd say.
Well, there's a lot to prove between these two.
And they're on big money as well. Spadafora is getting hit a lot, though. Another right hand and another one. How many more? Mind you, Dorian has eye damage as well, and so does Spadafora.
Spadafora's face becoming a bit of a mess. He's unable to get out of the way of shots. He needs to move a little bit. I think these tactics are the wrong ones.
But you've got to give credit to Dorian. I mean, he's doing things in there that is making it hard for Spadafora to dominate with the jab. He's clever at getting himself into range, isn't he?
He is. It's the good work rate, really. He's picked up the work rate, Dorian. Catching the punches on the gloves and then coming back. And that right hand has been the key punch. Keeps throwing that and it keeps landing against the southpaw.
Yeah, I think he's watched a lot of Spadafora videos and he's seen that that is a weakness with the IBF champion. But this guy, Spadafora, is one of those fighters who always seems to find a way to win. He's never lost yet in 36. Dorian unbeaten in 21.
Yes, he's game and he's gutsy, Spadafora, and he's used to doing it the long route.
Yes, a little cracker so far here in Pittsburgh. Oh, another right from Dorian at the end of the round.
Baby. I get the best right there.
That's a bad, nasty cut there. Both fighters have picked up some injury here.
Spadafora looks the worst of the two. There wasn't a lot of blood coming from Doreen's.
You hear me?
Yeah.
Big left hook. He just keeps rolling forward. Both these fighters a little upright. But I think he's got the more of the technical ability than a Doreen.
Now round five. Blue trunks of the WBA champion Leonard Dorian, now fighting out of Montreal in Quebec, Canada.
Let him go, let him go. No hitting on the break.
He's got a good following there as well. Of course, Arturo Gatti fights out of Canada as well these days.
That's it.
Not to mention Kirk Johnson. Due to go in with Lennox Lewis on June the 21st, of course, for the World Heavyweight crown.
Well, a good exchange there with the better of the punches coming from Dorian, the left hook.
At the moment, Dorian looks the boss in there. I just get the feeling that Spadafora is just trying to hang on in the fight in the hope that he can claw things back. This is a fighter with a lot of bottle and grit about him, though, Spadafora.
But Ian, it looks as if he's lost a bit of confidence in there as his right hands keep going in from Dorian.
He's trying to get that left glove up a bit higher. He needs to block that right hand, otherwise Dorian is just going to keep on thumping that shot through all night long.
Spadafora needs to find something to stop that right hand coming. I think he needs to start putting combinations together himself, start letting his own left go.
And he's not noted it being a heavy-handed puncher, Dorian, but somehow in this fight he's looking it, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Certainly there's not a great deal of movement from Spadafora. And you know, I think he needs a few more angles.
It's a funny thing, isn't it? Spadafora is 27, Dorian's 33, but Spadafora is looking the old man of the two, if anything, isn't he?
Well, he's struggling in there. He's being pushed back behind the jab of Dorian, and then the right hand catching him time and time again.
I think he has a big battle with the scales as well, Spadafora, to get down to 9 stone 9, and again he's caught on the ropes by Dorian. He's just outworking him, out-hustling him all the way.
And there's blood under the left eye. A spot of four, and I don't know if that's just ran down or he's got a second cut.
This time, right leads from Dorry. Even though he's not a southpaw, just switched angles, came in square, lanced him with a couple of rights, just mixing it up cleverly.
Dorian that's got the bounce in his stab as he keeps pushing forward looking for good shots, and for me that was Dorian's round again,
and the Romanian fans celebrate.
Watch and win with Sky Box Office.
Jeez.
Every time you order the movie Spider-Man between the 14th of May and the 10th of June, you will automatically be entered into our free prize draw to win a trip to New York. Here you'll get a Spider-Man view of the city. From the top of the Empire State Building. So, take the ultimate spin and watch and win with Sky Box Office.
Welcome back to Pittsburgh.
That's right. You box all night. Box all night. That's all. Using that jab and box. That's right.
You can definitely do it, baby.
They're all pumped up in Spadafora's corner. I can do it. I can do it. It's all big positive vibes, but I don't know, are they whistling in the dark a bit? The way things are going, it doesn't look good for Spadafora. But you wouldn't write him out of it yet, would you?
No, you wouldn't. He's had tough fights before and come through. He is a winner. He's a good boxer, obviously got a good boxing brain. And he knows how to come back. But he's got something to do here because it's starting to slip away from him.
Dorian looks tough, confident. Like a man with something to prove. It's only his third world championship fight. The other two were both against Raul Balbi. The first a bit controversial. The second he won in Bucharest in his home country in front of a 6,000 crowd. He broke his elbow though in that fight, which is why he's been out for a year. I don't think there are too many signs of ring rust, are there?
Well, he's obviously worked hard in the gym in preparation for this fight because he's been sharp and he's been on target right from the start.
Spadafora looks slower to me than when I've seen him in the past as well tonight.
He does. He's worked long and hard for this fight in training camp for 11 weeks. So, you know, you wonder, maybe overtrained.
Yeah, well, has he left something in the gym, maybe? Possible. He had 6 weeks in California and five working locked away in the Pennsylvania countryside. Can he get this fight out at range? Can he keep Dorian on the outside? That seems to be the key. There's been absolutely no sign of it so far. Good spirit between the two fighters as they touch gloves there. A lot of respect. He has to start doing something differently, Spadafora.
Well, two nice little right hands from Spadafora, on the move a bit more now.
Again, the gloves just dropped completely, and then Dorian took advantage with the right hand that time.
Dorian not doing as much in this round. Some nice counter punches from Spadafora.
But I think a jab alone is not going to be enough for Spadafora to win this. Both Glenn and I have him behind significantly at this point, and Dorian again, who's quick, the way he closed the range there to get him with the right hand.
Dorian definitely standing off more in this round and missing with punches.
And to use the old cliche, it's educated pressure this, isn't it, from Dorian. Oh, and rocks him with the right hand, and this time it's not a shake of the head from Spadafora, it's a nod. He knew that was a good one. And that's Dorian for me again.
The time has come to capture the truth. The Samsung camera phone with rotating lens. Answer the call.
Big
know that he put his head on this side. You know that.
You're listening to the Doreen Corner. He must be pretty happy with the way this is going so far, because he's made it his kind of fight, hasn't he?
He has. He's rolled forward. He's caught all the shots on the gloves from Spadafora. And then he's got the little short hooks on. And he's really rocked the head of Spadafora, whose defense has been very, very poor. Look at that right hand. Big, strong punch acknowledged there by Spadafora.
Good feeling between the two boxers. Of the phony grudge match stuff, and they produced a good fight. The lightweight division has needed it too. Mayweather is a wonderful defensive artist, but it is defensive very much in italics with him, I'm afraid, in his recent fights. Spadafora, the taller fighter, with his back to you, with the advert plastered on his back. Don't like to see that, really. It doesn't look good. In fact, I think it should be banned, really.
Doreen pulling away on Michael. Last four rounds are given all to him. 59-55. Nice. So it's better for us something to do.
I've got it the same, Glenn. Doreen 4 points up. And again, this time a countering right as Spadafora tries to drive Doreen back with the right leads.
Keep him up.
Can the Romanian keep this up? I mean, it's not noted as a big boxing capital Romania. It is to World Championship boxing, really, what Spain is to test cricket or something like that.
Well, he's learned his game somewhere, Doreen, because he's very good technically, doesn't make a lot of mistakes. He's not the flashiest boxer in the world, but look at this
tremendous combination punching head and body from Doreen. You wouldn't mind seeing him in with Mayweather, would you, really?
Well, you'd like to see it. You know, he catches the shots. He's educated.
Spadafora's big army of fans here must be worried by what they're watching. But we repeat again, Doreen might have to win this pretty big to get it here. Shouldn't be the way, but it often is, too often.
Well, Spadafora just trying to come back with a combination. He needs a lot more than that. Doreen looks the confident of the two, bouncing his legs and looking in and out of range and then coming through with nice little combinations.
And what can Spadafora do here about this, do you think, Glenn? Well, strategically, technically.
Early on, he was putting combinations together. That stopped. He's looking for jabs. He's looking for single shots. He's got to start throwing punches. You know, he's went to the body a lot to bring the hands down. He's got to start throwing straight shots, stepping around.
I mean, so easy to hit, isn't he, tonight, Spadafora? That's a bit better. Straight right, then he followed in with the left hand that time. But he's just having trouble keeping Doreen away from him. That's a bit more like it if he can produce more of the same.
Well, even then, he's throwing shots, but they're landing on the gloves. They're not really getting through.
And there's been no lateral movement, really, either, to go with it. You've got to give that to Doreen again. I think he's in a big lead here.
Is there anything you need?
It's okay, I've got my own deodorant.
When will I see you again?
Well, I'm okay for the next 79 nights.
The new Nivea Deodorant Compact with 24-hour protection. It's only small on the outside.
From the makers of Kiss of the Dragon and Leon, The Transporter. Rent it, buy it on video and DVD from Monday.
Always off balance, Coach Yu. You hear me? Leonard.
Well, they're happy, I think, with what Doreen's doing, and this was really the combination punching of the night from Doreen.
Well, you had to be happy with that. There was even a little head went in at the end of that exchange.
Down, hey. Nice and clean. Stay up there.
Eighth round, and Spadafora has got a big job to do if the scorecards of Glenn and I are any guide. I've got it by 5 at this point to Doreen, the WBA champion. In his amateur days, he twice beat world champion Marco Rudolph. That's a measure of his quality. And he stopped Tonto Tonchev in a couple of rounds to win the European Championship in 1996. This is high class form, isn't it?
Very, very high class. You know, the best in the world as an amateur, right up there. And you know, he's brought that through to the professional ranks, and with a style that, you know, is pretty technical but not flashy. You know, he doesn't floor that well, but he does a good job.
Well, it's a good mix, isn't it, I think, between boxing and a bit of brawling as well. He's not a heavy puncher, but he has cut up Spadafora tonight.
Hold on. Keep it clean on the break.
Keep it clean on the break, says Rudy Battle, the experienced referee. Well, I suppose somebody's O has to go tonight. Both undefeated so far.
Well, so far in, it looks like Spadafora is the one ready for his first defeat, unless he can turn it round.
It's a bit better from Spadafora. He's getting that jab working in this round, doubling up on it too. Cracking right hand, and wasn't it fast as well from Dorin?
Well, Dorin just picks his shot so well, then moves out of range. The jab comes in from Spadafora but misses.
Spadafora is doing a little bit better in this round. He's working harder, a little less coming from Dorin.
It's still in the shots that matter, the shots that seem to connect the better come from Dorin.
Here I am.
Maybe not just quite as accurate in this round, apart from that big right that he got through with Dorin.
Well, Spadafora looking to move, getting out of that corner well, and throwing a couple of punches.
Now he's starting to get some lateral movement into it now, move off to the side, just change the angles. Instead of standing in front of Dorin, that he's done something he's done for most of the night.
Throwing a few more punches now, Spadafora.
Well, they think he's got it in the bag, the Romanian fans of Leonard Dorin. Close that last round. Maybe Spadafora won his first session just in a long while.
Remember what we work on? He's getting them all. You hit him with the right hand as much as you want now.
Yeah.
Now you're going to keep your shoulder a little bit in the back. All right? You're going to try to knock him out this round.
You need these rounds. They're full combinations. Let's get the...
You got four rounds, baby.
Hey, when you go out, spin the back leg. Don't go straight back. He's hitting you with the right hand.
Jesse Reed working the cuts, by the way, for Spadafora tonight, because his usual cut man is unavailable. I wonder if Jesse Reed knew it would be this busy a night. No wonder there's so much blood around. Glenn Dorin's from Dracula country, isn't he? Romania.
Hey, nice and clean.
Ninth round. Spadafora still with work to do here. Four rounds left in this. And maybe Dorin about that far in front. Maybe. So the last round. Who knows how the judges are seeing it.
So in the last round, Spadafora picked up the work. I think he knows what he's got to do. He knows it's going to be a tough way for him to get back in the fight. He's got to throw a lot more punches.
Good right hand from Spadafora. He suddenly starts to look a bit more composed, and the crowd, sensing the change in mood in the fight, start to get behind their man. Maybe they're thinking it might not be a lost cause after all.
And now Spadafora, who's looking to take centre of the ring, he walks forward, taking the fight to Dorin.
Just a bit cuter now, Spadafora. Something seems to have gone out of Doreen. It's possible that one of these punches just caught him and knocked a bit of something out of him.
Well, he's just slowed down, showing a little bit more respect to Spadafora.
All right, let him go.
He's now lancing out that right lead to greater effect. And this is what we thought we'd see from Spadafora from the beginning.
Well, Spadafora maybe feels a bit of the strength, a bit of the buzz has gone out of Doreen. Something seems to have.
And listen to the crowd now. They sense that somehow the electrical current has been switched off in Doreen for the time being.
Maybe just hitting that point in a fight where it all starts to get hard. There's a little wall there when you wait for your second wind, and it seems as if Doreen has just hit that,
like the marathon runner getting to about 17 miles.
Yeah, it always comes. If you've done your work, you get through it.
Spadafora has outboxed Doreen in this round. And it's not often we've been able to say that in this fight. There's definitely been a switch in the plot. I saw first signs within the last round. And Spadafora has built on that in quite a big way. And he's having his best round of the fight here. Definitely his round. That one goes to the IBF champion. Could be quite a finish, this. There's now a fever pitch atmosphere in the arena, Glenn.
What tremendous atmosphere. They really dubbed that grease. I'm not really sure what they've got in there.
Looked like a jar of honey.
As soon as you close, I want to see the right hook here. Yeah. As soon as you get close, short right hook, follow with the left then. Keep digging the right hook.
Okay, everyone, speed. You forget about speed, Bill. Yeah. Speed and tuck chin.
He looks more tired, Dory.
Yeah, mentally tired. I think that's the corner. They've got to do more work. They've got to try and get him up. Bring something else out of Doreen.
And this is round 10. Doreen built up a biggish lead by halfway. At one point, I had him 5 points ahead. On my card, that's down to 3 now. And there are 3 rounds left. Spadafora might need them all.
Well, I think mine's very similar to yours here in 87-84 in Doreen's favour, but notice this, Spadafora coming back.
Just needs to re-establish himself a little, Doreen. Every round, I notice one of the cornermen says to Doreen, go out there and knock him out.
Nice right hook inside from Spadafora, and it's Doreen who backs up.
Spadafora is a tough guy. His dad died of a drug overdose. He was shot in the leg by a policeman. He's come up the hard way. And there's a fair bit of grit about this performance. He's been through some bad times in this fight, but he's beginning to come through the fog.
Well, he is a little bit. I think you could be right with Doreen, just starting to tire. He did a lot in the early rounds, but a good right hand from him there.
This is absolutely fascinatingly poised at the moment. Doreen again with the right hand. He's just picked up the pace a little again. And he's dabbing away now at the left eye, Spadafora. I wonder if the blood's starting to run into that. Yes, it's worse. It's a lot worse, that left eye of Spadafora. They can have boxing, big time boxing, back in Pittsburgh again. Tell you what, your old hero, Harry Greb, out of Pittsburgh, he would have approved of this, wouldn't he?
He certainly would have. This is back to his sort of day when they really give their all, and yet the legendary Harry Greb from these parts.
The only man to beat the great Gene Tunney is Greb. Died on the operating table, routine op. Some correction problem with his nose at the age of 32. I think they gave him too much anaesthetic. I suppose those things used to happen in those days.
It took a lot to stop a heart as big as Harry Greb's.
Break.
Last half minute, round 10. These two are now just beginning to see the finishing post in the distance. Close one, this one.
This one's a close one, yet not a great deal in it. Doreen started to land with her cleanest shots again. Maybe his confidence coming back to him. He's got through the fog a bit.
Better from Doreen. He touched gloves again at the end of the round.
Beautiful round, beautiful.
Winner! Stop being the nice guy, okay? This guy wants you bad, he wants you alive. Stop being the nice guy, all right?
I don't think they like him touching gloves with Spadafora like that at the end of the round.
It's over, all right?
Yeah.
Eleanor, he's waiting for you with that right hook to the head. Yeah. You know that.
Yeah.
Can you give me speed on the right hand? You tease with your jab like you do now.
Yeah.
On your toe.
Deep breath.
Right hand to the body, left hook to the head. Very fast.
Well, they're seeing plenty in those corners, an awful lot to take in, but notably the eye is bleeding again. That eye just worsened a bit.
Liberal amounts of grease to keep Spadafora in business. Well, they've been fighting with these injuries quite a while now. I don't think they're going to be a factor in this late.
11.
Round 11. We're into the championship rounds here, aren't we?
Yeah, this is where it's won or lost. This is where you prove if you've got it. These are the hard rounds.
I think Spadafora needs this one pretty big. He's needed most of them for a while. Doreen almost sucked up some air there. Not worried a bit about fighting in the other guy's backyard, is he? Couldn't care less.
Well, we talk about how hard it is doing the 12 rounds these days, and Harry Greb's there. He had 1 year, he had 46 fights, almost all 10 or 15 rounders.
Is that all?
In 1 year.
Don't get Glenn on Harry Greb, he'll go on all night. Oh, that's a good right hand from Doreen that time. And Spadafora again left his left glove hanging around by his hip. And you can see what's happened with those right hands. That's why he's got all that damage by the left eye.
So look at Doreen again. Look at the spring he's got in his step. The arm's starting to go. Look how much he's changed in the last couple of rounds. That's when you get past that wall, you get your second wind, and you start to feel good again.
Wonder how the judges have got it. There was a row about who exactly was going to be the judges. A lot of political manoeuvring. Doreen's people making complaints beforehand. We've got Pat Russell, Guillermo Pineda, and Gary Merritt, who is often used by the IBF. Pineda, a WBA appointed official. There's a bit of politics involved. You always worry about that, don't you, with the scorecards as well.
But it's still, for me, Doreen that's getting the cleanest shots on. The work of Spadafora is ragged. He's trying hard.
But he's stopped getting that jab away again, Spadafora. Now, Doreen has almost resumed the old service, hustling away. Just doing that little bit more, it seems. Spadafora, I think, just lost his balance on a wet patch in the centre ring. Quite clever, Doreen, at landing that right hand, the right, and then getting away again.
Decent left hand there as Doreen came in from Spadafora. Crowd react to almost everything Spadafora throws.
Well, I just wonder how the judges have got this.
It's your whole life, baby. It's your whole life. Get the water in front.
I have to say, I've got Doreen in a clear lead going into this last round.
This is where you work with your heart. Put the water in there. Put the water in there, Tommy.
This is where you work with your heart, says Jesse Reed. To Spadafora.
Speed. Give us some speed. Yes. All right?
Okay.
Give us some speed, Leonard. You're okay, man. We're doing the good round. Can you put your left hook in the
And you finish strong, Leonard.
Yeah. Keep using your jab.
That's all. Listen, use your jab and cough.
When you get all this, I tell you what, it makes me think that the British Boxing Board of Control have got to get us up to the present and let us have microphones in the corners in Britain as well. It adds to the drama, doesn't it?
Of course it does. It's the spectacle of boxing, of what's going on in the corner, the drama that's happening, the pep talks they have to give, the motivation.
And boxing isn't in such good shape that it can afford to ignore that kind of advantage with the public. Last round of this one. It's been a tremendous performance, I think, this by Leonard Doreen.
5 points ahead on Mike Orr. Doreen's back, winning the last two.
Bit low, that right hand of Spadafora. Rudy Battle lets him know about it. And Spadafora tried to find his way back into this somewhere around the eighth and ninth rounds, and it did seem as if possibly he could claw things back again, but Doreen picked up the pace once more, and somehow he's always looked fresher, he's always looked the boss, he's always looked that bit busier. He's made it much more his kind of contest, imposed his will. That's how it's looked to Glenn and I here. No knockdown. Looks tired, Spadafora now. Almost ashen-faced, you'd say. He's put a lot into this to stay in the fight. It's a good left countering. It stopped Doreen right in his tracks. But he might possibly even need the knockout here unless the judges are going to do him huge favours in his hometown.
Well, I'm sure he feels he's behind. Starting to throw a lot more punches, the crowd reacting for Spadafora.
Crowd have enjoyed it. It's been one of the best fights for a World Lightweight Championship in some time, this. The famous old 9-stone, 9-pound division that gave you people like Benny Lennon and Henry Armstrong, Duran, Arguello, Chavez and the rest.
Yes, a message to Floyd Mayweather, take notice. People like to see a bit of excitement. His Doreen eye has gone now, he's bleeding pretty heavily, the right eye.
Yeah, bad damage by that right eye now for Doreen. He's glad that this is the last round. There's a good left hook as well from him.
Maybe on the break, that one. Spadafora coming on strong in the last.
Pumped home a good body punch as well. Gutsy character, Spadafora. But is this the first defeat of his professional career? Oh, it's another right from Doreen, goes thudding home. Not quite as accurate though, Doreen, with his punches in this last round.
Well, Spadafora won this one, but I don't think he's done enough.
Me neither. There goes the final bell, a stirring fight between these two. Really worth the name of a unification battle at lightweight. And look at the face of Leonard Doreen. But if Glenn and I's scorecards are anything like correct, you're looking at the face of a winner. But will he get it? Will he get it in Spadafora's hometown?
Well, he did enough. He was the boss. He did the better boxing, the cleaner punches. And he got through with some good ones, Doreen. It was gritty, and he tried hard, but for me, Doreen's win.
Pat Russell, Guillermo Pineda, the WBA-appointed judge, and Gary Merritt, the IBF-appointed judge, will decide. We're ready with the decision now, I think. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecard. Judge Pat Russell scores the bout 115-113. For Leonard Doreen. Judge Guillermo Perez Pineda scores the bout 115-114 for Paul Spadafora.
All depends on the last one.
And Judge Gary Merritt sees it. 114, 114. We have a draw. Both contestants retain their title.
That is pretty incredible to me. That is a hometown decision, and no two ways about it. Doreen was a clear winner. I had it by four. You had it by what, Glenn?
I had it by 4 points. You see it on Doreen's face. He's shocked by that. He doesn't know, but I think he's been robbed of that decision.
Terrible, really. Leaves a bad taste in the mouth. There was only one winner there, and it was Doreen. And they're both unbeaten still, and they both keep their titles as a result of it. But that really was very, very controversial. The judges have done Spadafora a huge, huge favour. And that's what's wrong with boxing, isn't it? You could almost see it coming as well.
You could. A hometown decision, I think. But the good thing is, we'd probably get to see it all over again.
Larry Merchant's in there.
They gave it a draw. I feel that when I got that draw, I feel that I don't even want the fight.
Promise?
Like I promised you?
I'm Ben Tyson Boxer.
I came here to fight. I like to fight. I'm proud to be here with you. That's how I learned boxing.
Of course I'm disappointed. I thought I won the fight. I mean, they made a big deal about coming in our hometown, and I guess they did the managers and their promoter did a good job because he come to my hometown and they were biased towards me.
Asta nu m-a surprins. A fost o luptă între doi campioni.
There were two champions in the ring tonight.
Și amândoi am făcut box în seara asta.
I think we did a good job.
Please, Leonard Dorn's people, please, Mike Gregory, let's run it back and see what we can do from here.
He wants a rematch, do you?
Vrea revanșă.
Anytime.